Hey, what's up, everyone? And once again, welcome back to Super Mario 64 on the Super Mario 3D All-Stars Collection. Last time, we took on a few more stars, one from each of the four courses that we've opened up, and a secret star or two, unlocked the wing cap, and then fought Bowser and kicked his butt, and acquired a key for doing so. And in this episode, we're gonna head down into the basement down here and use that key to unlock this door. Now, technically, there is one more course we could have been going to this whole time that I've been completely neglecting. And I should probably go not neglect that course anymore. But hey, that door's unlocked. That door is unlocked. Over here, there's a little Boo waiting for us. And if we go out of this door, we are outside in the castle's courtyard. Which is just a really cute little place. I like this place. And this is where the infamous L is real 2401 meme came from. Not even really a meme, it was before the time of memes. I am trying to ground pound these guys and they are dogpiling me. I've also personally never seen L is real 2401 written on this statue. If you don't know what that is, people thought that Luigi was in the game when this game first came out, and they thought that it said L is real 2401 right there on this statue. I don't see it, personally. Like, I really don't. It just looks like a bunch of lines. So, anyway, right out here, if we go and defeat this Boo right here, it gives us this thing, and then Mario decides to jump on into it. Welcome to Big Boo's Haunt. Go on a ghost hunt. This is course number 5. Let's do this thing. Come on in here! Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. I'm gonna go on inside the house, though, because they asked so nicely. Alright, so once we're inside here, all we really have to do- Oh, yeah. Evil piano. Just wanted to point that out. Once we're inside here, we- Leave me alone! We gotta kill all the Boos. There's a bunch of Boos in this place. If you couldn't guess that from the name Big Boo's Haunt, we gotta defeat them all.
Ghosts don't die! Can you get out of here alive?
I mean, yeah, I could just walk out of the door, if I'm being honest with you. This right here is Mr. I, and if you just circle him a few times, he becomes Mr. Die and gives you a blue coin. How nice of him. How nice of him. So yeah, just go around all these rooms, defeat all the Boos you find, and that's it. Really? That is really it. Ugh! There's another Boo! Yeah, I know, ghosts don't die, whatever. Whatever you want to say. Each one gives you a blue coin, too. You could possibly do... Oh, I haven't even brought that up yet. Every level has a 100 coin mission. So, you're gonna have to collect 100 coins in these courses, and then you get an extra star for doing that. There's a chance you could do it here just by defeating these Boos. There's a lot of these dudes. There's a heck of a lot of these dudes. I believe we want to go here and then jump down? Yeah, this takes us down to the lower level right here. And as you saw there, we took some damage, but then surfaced and suddenly didn't have any damage on us. What's going on in here? Nothing, it's just a weird carousel for now. Okay, cool. Good to know. Good to know. How the heck do I get out of here? Is it this way? I think it's this way. Yeah, so this, once we go through here... Where does this lead to again? Oh, that's right, there's an elevator. And I believe this actually takes us outside of the mansion. Because, we've just gone into the sewers, but- Ah! That wasn't fair! How was I supposed to see you? You can disappear now, Mr. I. Yeah, so once we leave here, we're now outside. But we, of course, have to go back inside because we didn't defeat all the Boos. So going into the basement was the wrong move. I thought that there was something down there, but I'm thinking of somewhere else. I keep getting my rooms mixed up. Is this the one we need to be in? I actually don't know if this is the intended way of doing this, but I think you can like jump your way up to the top floor by doing this. Am I wrong? I could very well be wrong. Yeah, I'm probably wrong. I'm probably wrong, if we're being honest here. Did I go in this room yet? I did go in this room. Would you believe me if I told you I actually don't remember what to do now? All I know is you have to defeat all the Boos, and I thought I did that. But I guess we didn't do that. Oh, wait, I think I just remembered where there's one more Boo. I think I just remembered. And I believe we actually have to go around the outside of the house? because you can hear him. Not that means anything, that he's just playing on the soundtrack, but I think if you go this way and you enter this door, this is like a back room. And then there's a boo in here. Yep, there's a boo. Oh, there's a couple of boos. Yeah. Ghosts don't die. Ghosts don't die. I get it. But you can disappear and give me your money.
A boom, the big tariff to the big boo.
I kind of skipped the dialogue there without intending to, but that said something about big boo. Ooh. So if we now go over this way, we go back into the house. Oh god, he's right there. It scared the crap out of me. Meet Big Boo. He sounds like a thwomp. You can just ground pound him a few times, he's dead. It's really that simple. He honestly terrified me. Good god. And then these turn into stairs, and we can grab our power star. Here we go. Also, I'd just like to point out, I'm recording two episodes in a session. This is the second episode of two, and I completely forgot to pay attention to, like, what time I started recording this one. So this episode might run over a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. I see you coming for me, Boo. It's not happening today, buddy. Alright, there we go. That's one star from Big Boo's Haunt. How about we go and actually head downstairs now, like I was intending on doing at the start of the episode, and see what's going on down here. We have a door this way.
It takes the power of 30 stars to open this door. You need 16 more stars.
I know that wasn't Bowser saying that, but like, I just imagine that door sounds like Bowser, you know? Maybe. Alright, what do we got going on down here? Hello, Toad! Why are you hiding in the basement?
Wow, you've already recovered that many stars! Way to go, Mario! I'll bet you'll have us out of here in no time! Be careful, though! Bowser is banned,
He has a band?
Wrote the book on bad! Take my advice! When you need to recover from injuries, collect coins! Yellow coins refill one piece of the power meter, red coins refill two pieces, and blue coins refill five! To make blue coins appear, pound on blue coin blocks! Also, if you fall from high places, you'll minimize damage if you pound the ground as you land!
Alright. It's amazing how I can do a flawless Bowser voice with the growling and everything. But when I have to slightly growl for a Toad voice, it kills me. I can't do it. Also, this is scary. Let's do it. This, my friends. Oh, this is actually course 7. Whoops. Boil the big bully. Welcome to Lethal Lava Land. We're gonna go ahead and take on one of the ones here. Take on one of the stars here. Don't be a pushover. If anyone tries to shove you around, push back. It's one-on-one with a fiery finish for the loser. I kinda love and hate Lethal Lava Land. If I'm being honest, it's a really, really cool concept for an area. Like, everything is just floating on lava, which is really cool, but you can die so easily. And I have done- Oh, okay. What's this one called again? Boil the big bully. Well, this is the big bully. He's being a big bully, as you can see. Ow. He's being a big bully, as you can see. We just gotta punch him a few times. Punch him! Okay, ground pounds actually work a bit better, because you can hit him in the middle of the animation. Please stop it. We just gotta hit him off the get in the lava! I'm really messing up on this guy. You can also dive into them, you can kick him in the air. You can do anything to hit these guys, really. There we go, and he's in the lava, okay. And doing that will give us a power star. I tell you, some of the power stars in this game are not the most complex thing in the world. Some of them are, pretty easy. Pretty easy to get. Alright, Boil the Big Bully has been completed. And now we're gonna go find the actual course 6, which I believe is right through here. If I'm remembering this correctly. Actually, first, there's a Toad right here. Great, I get to do Toad's voice again.
Hold on to your hat! If you lose it, you'll be injured easily! If you do lose your cap, you'll have to find it in the course where you lost it! Oh boy! This is not
Are you Mickey Mouse now?
Oh boy! Why, it's not looking good for Peach! She's still trapped somewhere inside the walls, huh? Please, Mario, you have to help her! Now, did you know that there are enemy worlds inside the walls?
No. No idea about that, Toad.
Yup, it's true! Bowser's troops are there, too! Oh, here, take this, I'll be keeping it for you!
This Toad has a star. I don't know where he got that from, but I appreciate it, Toad. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now let's dive into this pool of goo. The actual Course 6 Hazy Maze Cave, with the first star Swimming Beast in the Cavern. Hazy Maze Cave is another one of those courses that I kind of have a love-hate relationship with. I love its aesthetic. I love how it looks. I love the music. I think it's very ambient, very nice. However, I get... Oh, we're dead. No, we're not. I get so confused in this place. Like, I get lost. Some of the stars have, like, very confusing names. It's a whole thing. If we go into first person, you can see there's actually a map right there. That's where we are. I didn't pay attention, but I think we started at the bottom left. So, yeah. We want to go down this elevator right here. And this is going to take us to the aforementioned cavern. Let's just jump to make it a bit faster. Here we go. This is the aforementioned cavern that was mentioned in the title. Okay. That's what aforementioned means, right? Previously mentioned. And there is our cute little flippin' swimming beast. Now, I always called this thing Dory as a kid. I forget- no, not as a kid, but like previously. I still don't know if it's actually called Dory or if it's Nessie. So, if you guys want to let me know in the comments which one this is, because I know that Dory is in the later games, I think, and looks a bit different. I could be totally wrong about that. But please, test my knowledge right there. All you gotta do is stand on it, ground pound it so it puts its head down, and then you can get on its head, it raises up its head as you saw, and then you jump to get the power star. Simple as that. So that's Hazy Maze Cave. We are already at 17 stars, my god. They're definitely gonna get a little bit more tough as we go along. It's just because we're taking on the first one of every world. And also, yes, this wall is a painting. Welcome to Course 8, Shifting Sandland in the Talons of the Big Bird. We're testing out all the courses today, folks. We're just, over the past few episodes, we're just rapid-firing these courses. We're not keeping anything as a prize. We're gonna open up all these courses, we're gonna let you guys take a look at them all. And then we're going to, just go at whatever pace we go at, you know? We're gonna just do it. We're just gonna go. We're gonna get the stars as we go, we're gonna open up all these courses so nothing's a surprise. And we're just gonna get on with it. And there's our big bird. We just gotta grab the star off of him. I'm doing these so fast, aren't I? And for some reason, grabbing the star makes him fall down. So, that's good. That's cool, I guess. But yeah, remember Toad was talking about don't lose your cap? That guy can actually grab your cap. And then you start taking damage. Which is no fun. You know, that's no fun. So, oh! Bunny! Yeah, don't let that happen. We want to catch this bunny, though, for sure. I missed him, god damn it. He appears after a certain amount of stars that I don't know the exact number of, but clearly we have enough. He wasn't in here when we first came down here, but he's here now. This is Mips.
Yo, unhand me, brute. I'm late, so late, I must make haste. This shiny thing? Mine, it's mine. Finders, keepers, losers. Take it then. A gift for Bowser it was. Now let me be. I have a date. I cannot be late for tea.
Are you the rabbit from Alice in Wonderland, or are you just conveniently getting tea? Anyway, there's another castle secret star. We're getting a lot of them this time around, aren't we? Oh, there is actually one more place we can go to, I believe. If we go back this way, there's a little door. And there's a little place that we can swim under. And once we go through this away, I do believe... I don't think this is a secret star, but it's like a secret thing.
Whoa! God damn it, Mario, what are you doing? What are you doing?
You stand on this pillar, give it a good old ground pound, and this one. For whatever reason, that drains the water. And then you can go outside and see that the moat is drained. And there's also coins right underneath the bridge. And upon having the moat drained, you can go in this hole. So never mind, there actually is a secret star here. Welcome to the Vanish Cap Switch course. All of the blue blocks you find will become solid once you step on the cap switch. It'll disappear when you put on the Vanish Cap, so you'll be able to elude enemies and walk through many things. Try it out! So yeah, much like the, excuse me, I just burped. Much like- oh, I already messed this up. We need to be up there. I think we can, like, backwards kick to get up there? Right? Am I wrong? I could very well be wrong. Might have to retry this. We're probably gonna have to retry this. Ah! But yes, much like the, I can't do this. Much like the wing cap, there's also a course here for the vanish cap, and I kind of already screwed up because there's a, as you can see, red coin up there that we kind of need to grab. Oh, I made it. Oh, I actually freaking made it up there. Okay, triple jump into weird dive kind of did it. All right. Very cool. Let's make sure we don't take much more damage here. I'll gladly take a one-up and this other one-up from down here. Thank you very much. Where do we want to go to next? I guess over here. Another one-up. Okay. Take this red coin. Take this red coin. And then I think we're actually just... we're just done, so we can just slide down. Don't hit me with your fireball. Don't you hit me with your fireball. So yeah, we want to grab all of these red coins, get to the end, and unlock the vanish cap. I was not expecting to be unlocking these two this quick. But I guess you do get them relatively early. There's three caps you can unlock, and I think the third one's like way, way later, now that I'm thinking about it. So we're not going to get that one for a while. No, I'm wrong. It's not way, way later. I'm thinking of something completely different. So we're actually going to be able to... Oh, God. Oh, Mario's just dead. Okay. We're going to be able to get all of the caps, like, fairly quickly. Fairly soon, I believe. All right, we need to, we need to give that another go. Because I kind of horribly messed that up. I'm very glad I managed to recover that first red coin after messing that up. But I kind of messed everything else up there, didn't I? I forgot that those platforms, like, flip over when they get to the top. Which, you know, is a problem because you die. But luckily they give you a boatload of one-ups at the start here, so... Not complaining about... Oh, no. Alright. Down we go, Mario. Down we go. It actually, I don't think, takes a life from you when you lose there. So you can kind of just grind one-ups in there if you want to. You know, much like the wing cap course, it just sends you out of the level when you're done. Or when you fall off, sorry. So, yeah, you can kind of just grind for one-ups, which is not a bad thing. You know, if you need those extra lives, which clearly I do. That one almost fell off the cliff, though. I am gonna go... I think it was just... This is the one with the three. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna grab this one. Grab this one. Okay. And then just avoid Mr. Fireball Man right here, and we're good. We finally made it back down here. We got 14 Marios. I think we're gonna be alright this time. I think I got this. I think I can do it. That's famous last words. I know it is, but... I can try. I can certainly try. There's no harm in trying. Okay, go. And then we want to go... I just tried to long jump. That was the worst option I could have chosen, but somehow it worked. Oh, oh, Mario, get up. Mario, how am I alive? I don't know how I'm alive. Why do I keep going back to the place that's going to kill me? Okay, this is where I want to be, and then I want to backflip. That's what I was trying to do. Good lord. Okay, Mario, get to the top, backflip up. Whew. Hit the switch. And there we go. You've just stepped on the Vanish Cap switch. The Vanish Cap makes Mario disappear. Now Vanish Caps will pop up from all over the blue blocks you find. Would you like to save? Yes, please. Let's go ahead and grab a Vanish Cap. We'll grab our last red coin. And that makes a star appear inside this cage. And you may be wondering, how do you get inside the cage? Well, I think you actually can just wall jump over it if you're good. Yeah, you can. You can totally wall jump over it right there. Like I just did. Or you can just run through it with the Vanish Cap. That's another thing that the Vanish Cap does for you. It makes you completely impervious to those kind of walls. Alright, and with that, folks, we're like a sixth of the way through the game already. Which is a little bit crazy, if I do say so myself. Was not expecting to be this far through in just three episodes. But I guess Mario 64 isn't the crazy longest game out there. Especially if you know how to actually play it. I don't know what the world... Oh, I fell down. I don't know what the world record is for 100% speedruns, but I'm sure it's only like a couple hours at most. There's no way that it's like a long time. 2-3 hours maybe? Probably even less than that. I'm probably talking out of my butt right now. Alright, I think to end off this episode, we'll do a couple more stars in some of the earlier levels. Also, we've taken damage because we got freaking fall damage out there. Let's just head back to Bob-omb Battlefield and do what we gotta do next, which is... Shoot to the island in the sky. I love this one. I really do. Excuse me, Mr. Ba-Bomb Buddy. Could you open the cannon for me? Are you the wrong one? Oh, yeah, you are. You're the right one. Okay, thank you, bud. Appreciate it. I really do be appreciating you opening that up for me. Ready for blast off? Yeah, yeah, we know how it works, bud. We know how it works. We get in the cannon and we fire. Alright, we're actually just gonna go... Well, there's the island we have to get to, but we're just going over that way first. Don't miss it, Mario! Oh, okay, perfect platform placement right there. We want to go up here, because there's actually another cannon right inside this one. And then this one will allow us to shoot up to the island, but you want to aim just for the tree and then go a bit higher. I think about there? That was too high, but I got the red coin. I got the red coin, if that means anything. That's okay, though, because there's another cannon conveniently placed right here for if you do mess it up, as I just did. So just aim for the tree, and then a little higher, and then boom, and you're in the tree. All right. And then if you go over here, you open up this box, you'll find a power star that we're going to immediately collect. 21, folks. We are speeding through this game. Absolutely speeding through this game. Alright. Let's go do another Wump's Fortress, why don't we? Because I actually found what time I started this video at, and I think we have... probably another 3-4 minutes left, so yeah, we'll do Wump's Fortress. We'll do some Wump's Fortress action. How about it? How about it? Oh, that's the wall, Mario. What are you doing, my guy? What are you doing? Shoot into the wild blue. Okay, another one that actually requires the cannon. Well, requires the cannon if you're not a speedrunner who knows how to glitch this one out. But does technically require the cannon. You want to go over here, talk to the Ba-Bomb. Hello? 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 Yeah, I'll prepare the cannon for you. Alright, please prepare that cannon for me. Yeah, you technically don't require the cannon for this one, but... I'm gonna use it anyway to show you how they intend for you to do this. And then if we mess up the cannon shot, we'll try a different way. Alright, you see that right there? See that little, I'm trying to get it in the middle. It's not working. There. And then go up. And then shoot. Hit that wall. Bonk. Fall down here. And star. Now what you can do is just go beneath here and wall jump up. Which I kind of want to do just to show you how to do it. Watch me mess it up and have to go get the cannon again. Whoop! Whoop! Yeah, there you go. First try. I really hope that was shoot into the wild blue. It was, okay. Because there's another one that kind of requires the cannon. But there we go. That's shoot into the wild blue. And I think on that note, folks, we are going to go ahead and call it an episode here. This one might be a tiny bit shorter, but I seriously don't remember what time I started this episode at on my recording, so I'm hoping this is somewhere between 20 and 25 minutes. Probably. Maybe. Anyway, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and of course let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.